And you know what they call a quarter pounder with cheese in Paris?
They don't call it a quarter pounder with cheese?
Oh, man, they got the metric system. They wouldn't know what the fuck a quarter pounder is.
And what do they call it?
They call it Royale with cheese.
Royale with cheese.
That's right.
What do they call a Big Mac?
Big Mac's a Big Mac, but they call it Le Big Mac.
Le Big Mac. What do they call a Whopper?
I don't know. I didn't go on a Burger King.
This is a tasty burger.
Why don't you tell my man Vince where you got the shit here at?
It's over there.
I don't remember asking you a goddamn thing. What country you from?
What?
What ain't no country I ever heard of? They speak English and what?
What?
English, motherfucker! Do you speak it?
Yes!
Then you know what I'm saying.
Yes.
Describe what Marcellus Wallace looks like.
What?
Say what again? Say what again? I dare you. I double dare you, motherfucker. Say what one more goddamn time.
He's black.
Go on.
He's bald.
Does he look like a bitch?
What?
Does he look like a bitch?
No!
Then why you try to fuck him like a bitch, Brett?
He didn't.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did, Brett. You tried to fuck him. And Marcellus Wallace don't like to be fucked by anybody except Mrs. Wallace.
My name is Lieutenant Aldo Rain, and I'm putting together a special team, and I need me 8 soldiers. 8 Jewish American soldiers. Now, y'all might have heard rumors about the Armada happening soon. Well, we'll be leaving a little earlier. We're gonna be dropped into France, dressed as civilians. And once we're in enemy territory, as a bushwhacking guerrilla army, we're gonna be doing one thing, and one thing only. Killing Nazis. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I sure as hell didn't come down from the goddamn Smoky Mountains, cross 5,000 miles of water, fight my way through half of Sicily, and jump out of a fucking aeroplane to teach the Nazis lessons in humanity. Nazi ain't got no humanity. They're the foot soldiers of a Jew-hating, mass-murdering maniac, and they need to be destroyed. That's why any and every sumbitch we find wearing a Nazi uniform, they're gonna die.
Damn. I can't see fucking shit out of this thing.
We ready or what?
Oh, hold on. I'm fucking with my hole. Oh, shit.
I just made it worse.
Who made this goddamn shit?
Willard's wife.
You make your own goddamn match.
Look. Nobody's saying they don't appreciate what Jenny did.
Well, if all I had to do was cut a hole in a bag, I could have cut it better than this.
What about you, Robert?
Can you see? Not too good. I mean, if I don't move my head, I can see you pretty good, more or less. But when I start riding, the bag's moving all over, and I'm riding blind.
I just made mine worse. Anybody bring any extra bags?
No, nobody brought an extra bag.
I'm just asking.
Do we have to wear them when we ride?
Oh, well, shit fire! If you don't wear them as you ride up, that just defeats the purpose.
Well, I can't see in this fucking thing. I can't breathe in this fucking thing, and I can't ride in this fucking thing.
Well, fuck all y'all. I'm going home.
Now, I watched my wife work all day getting 30 bags together for you ungrateful sons of bitches, and all I can hear is criticize, criticize, criticize. From now on, don't ask me or mine for nothing.
Now, look, let's not forget why we're here. We gotta kill a nigga over that hill there, and we gotta make a lesson out of him.
Okay, I'm confused. Are the bags on or off?
I think we all think the bag was a nice idea.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But not pointing any fingers, they could have been done better. So how about no bags this time, but next time we do the bags right, and then we go full regalia. Yeah.
Wait a minute. I didn't say no bags.
But nobody can see.
So?
So it'd be nice to see.
God damn it! This is a raid! I can't see, you can't see. So what? All that matters is can the fucking horse see? That's a raid!
Can't see shit!
Oh, fuck.
Is he a friend of yours?
Oh, Vincent, Marvin. Marvin, Vincent.
Better tell him to shut the fuck up, he's getting on my nerves.
Marvin. Marvin! Marvin! I'd knock that shit off if I was you.
Die, you motherfucker!
Marvin, what do you make of all this?
Man, I don't even have an opinion.
Well, you gotta have an opinion. I mean, do you think that God came down from heaven and stopped?
Oh, what the fuck's happening?
Oh, man.
Shit,
man. Oh, man, I shot Marvin in the face.
Why the fuck'd you do that?
When you came pulling in here, did you notice a sign on the front of my house that said Dead Nigger Storage?
Jimmy, you know I ain't seen no shit.
Did you notice a sign in the front of my house that said Dead Nigger Storage?
No, I didn't.
You know why you didn't see that sign?
Why?
Because it ain't there, because storing dead niggers ain't my fucking business. That's why.
Wer sind denn Ihre drei Fashion-Begleiter?
Ich befürchte, dass keiner von Ihnen ein einziges Wort Deutsch spricht. Es sind Freunde aus Italien. Dies hier ist der hervorragende Sensationsdarsteller Enzo Gorlone. Ein sehr talentierter Kameramann, Antonio Margheriti. Und Antonios Kameraassistent Dominique de Cocco. Signori, questo è un vecchio amico mio, Colonnello Hans Landa della SS.
Buongiorno.
Signore, è un piacere. Gli amici della vedetta ammirata da tutti noi, questa gemma propria della nostra cultura, saranno naturalmente accolti sotto la mia protezione per la durata del loro soggiorno.
Grazie.
Gorlomi? Lo pronuncio correttamente?
Sì, corretto.
Gorlomi? Per cortesia, me lo ripeti ancora.
Gorlami.
Mi scusi, con me?
Gorlami.
Ancora una volta.
Gorlami.
E come si chiama lei?
Antonio Margheriti.
Ancora?
Margheriti.
Un'altra volta, ma adesso vorrei proprio sentire la musica delle parole.
Margheriti.
Margheriti. E lei?
Dominic de Cocco.
Come?
Dominic de Cocco.
Bravo. Bravo.
Jimmy, lead the way. Boys, get to work.
Please would be nice.
Come again?
I said a please would be nice.
Get it straight, Buster. I'm not here to say please. I'm here to tell you what to do. And if self-preservation is an instinct you possess, you better fucking do it and do it quick. I'm here to help. If my help's not appreciated, lots of luck, gentlemen.
No, 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 Mr. Wolf. It ain't like that. Your help is definitely appreciated.
Mr. Wolf, listen. I don't mean disrespect, okay? I respect you. I just don't like people barking orders at me, that's all.
If I'm curt with you, it's because time is a factor. I think fast, I talk fast, and I need you guys to act fast if you want to get out of this. So, pretty please, with sugar on top. Clean the fucking car.
Have you ever heard that?
Get the fuck out of my face with that shit. The motherfucker said that shit never had to pick up itty bitty pieces of skull on account of your dumb ass.
I got a threshold, Jules. I got a threshold for the abuse that I will take. Now, I'm a fucking race car, right? And you got me in a red. And I'm just saying that it's fucking dangerous to have a race car in a fucking red. That's all. I could blow.
Oh, you ready to blow?
Yeah, I'm ready to blow.
Well, I'm a mushroom cloud laying motherfucker. Every time my fingers touch brain, I'm Superfly TNT. I'm the guns of the Navarone. In fact, what the fuck am I doing in the back? You the motherfucker should be on brain detail. We fucking switching. I'm washing the windows and you picking up this nigga's skull.
Pushing the clothes. Perfect. We couldn't have planned this better. You guys look like... What do they look like, Jimmy?
Dorks. They look like a couple of dorks.
Ha, ha, ha. Your clothes, motherfucker.
Come on, gentlemen. We're laughing our way right into prison. Don't make me beg.
You let him go! You let him go! Let go of him!
Tell that bitch to be cool.
I'm gonna kill you!
Say, bitch, be cool!
Be cool, honey.
Say, bitch, be cool! Tell that fucking bitch to chill!
Be cool, honey.
Chill that fucking bitch out!
Chill out, honey. Just chill out, honey bunny.
All right, now tell her it's gonna be all right.
It's gonna be all right.
Promise her.
I promise.
Tell her to chill.
Just chill out, honey bunny.
All right, now tell me your name.
Yolanda.
All right, now Yolanda. We're not gonna do anything stupid, are we?
Don't you hurt him.
Nobody's gonna hurt anybody. We're all gonna be like three little Fonzies here. And what's Fonzie like? Come on, Yolanda, what's Fonzie like?
It's cool.
What?
Cool.
Correctamundo. And that's what we're gonna be.
John Ruth says you got a Lincoln letter.
I told you, jackass, go hee-haw someplace else.
That's right, John. You did say that, did you?
Yeah, I did.
So, you got a letter from Abraham Lincoln?
Yes.
The Abraham Lincoln?
Yes.
Abraham Lincoln, the president of the United States?
Yes.
Of America?
Yes.
Wrote you a letter personally.
Yes.
Personally as in Dear Major Warren?
No, personally as in Dear Marquess.
Dear Marquess, Abraham Lincoln, the President of the United States of America.
Yes.
May I see it?
No, you may not.
But the way John tells it, you weren't just some random nigger soldier picked from a pile of letters. The way John tells it, y'all had a correspondence.
Yes.
The way John tells it, y'all was practically pen pals.
Yes.
And a pen pal's practically a friend. John Ruth. You really think a nigger drummed out of the cavalry with a yellow stripe down his back was practically friends with the President of the United States of America? John Ruth, I hate to be the one to break it to you, but ain't nobody in Minnie's haberdashery ever corresponded with Abraham Lincoln. Least of all, that nigger there.
Was all that horseshit?
Of course it was.
Good one, Warren. Talk that sass, nigga. Talk that sass.
You to go in that bag and find my wallet.
Which one is it?
It's the one that says bad motherfucker. That's it. That's my bad motherfucker. Open it up. Take out the money.
I think we should be leaving now.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea.